lot of new venues out there. Actually, a quick plug. This Wednesday, Smashing Clash is back.
Yeah, at the one bar location. I can't remember the name.
Yeah, it's I believe it's 34th Street in University City. I think it's the something Street Common.
Okay.
I'll get that information for you after this. But right now, we're going to go into the first game of Grand Finals. On winner's side, you have 6WX against loser's side, C3PO.
Yep. All around, so far, pretty even.
The Super Saiyan versus Frieza.
Banana's just sitting there. It's about
that down throw was really good because it forces
back
you to either
challenge that flip.
Oh,
that was
almost.
Yeah. Very nice patience there on C3PO. Just waiting for that.
Honestly, if 6WX would have landed that might have set the match. Mm-hmm. But good on C3PO for waiting it out just a little bit longer.
See if Diddy can get a fair amount of percentage back up on here. And that banana should apply pressure. It should cut off a lot of 6WX's pressure with that spin dash.
Yeah, but one thing that Sonic has going for him is that you're not always locked in the spin dash. You can shield cancel.
Yeah.
You can go right into a grab. So it's a lot safer because of it.
Yeah, you can mind game a lot with just going out of it normally, too.
People always like to talk about how Sonic
gets the banana slammer!
And C-3PO takes the first stock with that awesome banana in the down air and almost gets it again. Let's see how 6WX reacts, but that was an awesome first stock for C-3PO. That is what he wanted to see.
Mm-hmm. Basically said, Sonic, you need more potassium. So,
ooh,
fed him that banana.
6WX, tries to go for a rock forward smash. C-3PO likes to stay in shield quite a bit, so it's going to be rare that he falls for that.
Making great uses. Oh, okay, yeah, we can do that. Yep. Yeah. Sonic comes in,
good.
Up smash,
I will take it.
1-1.
Ooh, gets a little bit of double damage and 0-72 right now. 6WX is feeling the pain. And this will be some massive damage. It's not going to be a kill, but rest in pieces.
Tries to get back and forth rolls on trying
that
to get a
detail.
grab.
How
back
that
roll,
detail
back roll.
Out. I have no idea. How that hit.
Tries to go in with back air, not too far out, but he gets
there.
Yeah,
6WX is trying to regain control of this match right now.
Yeah, 119. He's got to play very careful. Any sort of down tilt can spell doom for Sonic right now.
I think another thing with Diddy Kong is that because of the fact that he can overwhelm the neutral, a lot of cerebral players that rely on analyzing don't have the opportunity to just sit back and look and see how their opponent is playing.
Right. That's true.
They have to continuously act and make sure that they're not caught in traps. So, although Diddy Kong players have some weaknesses in their game, and Diddy Kong as a character has some weaknesses, it's kind of mitigated by the fact that there's constant pressure being thrown at their opponent.
Right. That flip kick able to take out Sonic's neutral there.
It's not going to be good. Up tilt takes the stock. Surprisingly strong.
Yep, and where's the mouse?
C-3PO takes game one of Grand Finals. Now remember, C-3PO is coming from the loser's bracket, so he will have to win 3 out of 5 and then another 3 out of 5 in order to take it. But that was a good, strong showing from C-3PO to start this set.
Okay.
So where do you think 6WX should go here?
Probably someone without platforms.
I have a feeling that C-3PO banned Duck Hunt. So actually, they're going to go to Smashville again.
Okay.
It's kind of an interesting choice.
I kind of like it.
I don't know if I necessarily agree with it, only because I know that this is C-3PO's favorite stage.
Okay. Oh, yeah. Okay. I can see that, actually.
But, I mean, it could be 6WX's stage. It could be a comfort pick. Smashville, even though it's a smaller stage, it actually benefits defensive characters more because of the platform. A lot of players tend to use that platform a lot to just wait and then bait out things.
Yeah, but Sonic is known for just doing his best when he has control of the main stage, so.
Ooh. Oh, good up B.
Yeah.
Kind of used it like Pac-Man's trampoline. Oh, trip. That's not going to be good.
Okay, standard jab. All right. Back
good,
air.
Good conversion by 6WX. Oh, good stop.
Ooh,
right
wow,
there.
Good position on that, yeah.
That was really risky by 6WX.
Gets him at 122, and he's off stage, but he has the platform to recover on. Gets back on main stage.
Oh
yeah.
Punishes that. But again, that momentum, that Diddy Kong, and that's not gonna, that's not gonna be good. Good DI.
Just survives it.
This is not good. Oh, good
actually
job by 6WX.
Very nice.
Oh, four wrong option there, yeah.
Yeah.
A bit of jumping on the top of the water there.
And back and forth bananas.
And that's
forward air almost takes
almost
it out.
Almost takes it. Sonic had an astounding 181.
You usually don't see Sonic survive that long.
I know what I would do if I was in this situation.
The back air. Oh, so close.
And back that air. Back air is going to take it.
All
Super
right.
strong option. And finally, Sonic, who was all the way up at the 180s.
Yeah, it's surprising.
Ooh, punishes that. Ooh.
Ooh, threw the banana. Wow.
That was crispy.
Tries to get that down there.
Oh, Spring beats up that combo.
Yeah. Chose to go forward throw because the back.
Oh, banana in the forward smash.
Yep. All right, so still definitely in 6WX's grasp.
Detail, detail, detail. Jabs out of it. Good punish on that. C3PO trying to be a little bit tricky on that wake up, but
I want to see
it was
him
a little bit too.
I want to see him use the spin dash more as a mix up on this Diddy. Like he sort of
oh,
did
no.
in terms of recovery there, but on stage I want to see it a little bit more.
6WX just missing these confirms right now.
Hmm.
Not doing the optimal damage that he could be doing. We're gonna see Monkey Flip back to stage, air dodges. Because why not? And that just stops spin dash.
Yeah. Comes in with a forward air of his own. Grabs and throws. Great pressure. We'll see. Nope. No back air. Neutral air. Kind of stunted both of them, though.
Freeze it for now.
Banana cut him off on that approach.
Up there. Gets the forward air. And now things are looking really even.
Mm-hmm.
What seemed like C-3PO having a little bit of an advantage this whole game is now down to at least 10 to 15%. That's pretty close. Oh,
now 6WX
not able to punish it.
Playing very cautiously, bringing that shield at, just choosing the right time.
Oh, this
to go
is
in.
Not going to be good for C-3PO. Massive damage against Sonic. Sonic being an actually high damage character, despite his archetype.
Choosing the right time to move in. 6WX is playing really well right now. Good shield and banana. Oh,
that almost
could
was.
Have, yeah.
I think C3PO was a little bit surprised to even land in that. Oh,
almost. Even goes for the high.
Both characters at death percent right now. And Diddy Kong does not want to be above Sonic.
Yeah, he just went off to the right there.
And that's
nope.
Gonna be strong, but not enough. Oh, tries to go for that.
Oh, oh
the,
was
reverse
that the flip
monkey
kick?
Flip.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Wow.
Manages
oh,
to catch
control.
Him.
Sorry.
It'll be interesting to see what happens here. I wouldn't go back to Smashville.
I guess, yeah, after...
I think now it's time not to. They're going to go...
After what you said before, yeah, that's true.
Ooh.
Oh, my God, Lylat.
Lylat.
Oh, boy.
It's a very odd pick. You don't see this a lot, but... It's very interesting. I think it gets a little bit more of a bad rap than it should deserve.
Okay.
But I don't think the edges are nearly as bad after they patched it. But Lylat's actually a pretty good pick because Diddy has a little bit of a harder time dealing with where the banana lands on the tilting stage. So
yeah, that's true. That's true.
Lylat's usually a good pick against characters with projectiles. Because the tilting
yeah,
stage usually
the
has it in front of them.
Right.
The banana kind of plays into it, but also more that the banana lands on the top platform, which Diddy Kong sometimes doesn't want all the time.
Okay.
Yes. Meanwhile, Sonic doesn't really care. He has a good recovery. He has a good snapping recovery. Rarely does he get stuck under it. It's a decent amount of space. It's a good, I think this is a good.
Oh wow! Just went in with that up air and said, you know what? Throw another one in.
CGBL
just in case.
Just not afraid of 6WX's Sonic right now.
Oh, shield.
And again,
there.
He just loves to stay in shield. All right, there you go, man. Wow, the force nice. Match, it just evens things out.
Right now, it's just being a little more unpredictable here. Just choosing to go with those rolls and trying to catch C3PO off his game a little bit.
Yeah, and that's another thing. That monkey flip is affected by the tilt a little. If it tilts up and he monkey flips into it, he has more recovery on his, that landing line.
Spot dodge to get out of that grab, but it's going to zoom. Trying to find some banana play here for C3PO. 6WX grabs.
There you go. He's off stage now. Oh, sure. Tries to get that spring. Oh, not able to punish it. C3PO slippery. Gets away. Oh, good mix up.
Good latch on, yep. 6WX comes charging in with that spin dash. Gets a pretty good amount of damage on it. Right now he's looking for this kill that'll send him into a reset here. Oh no, sorry, not. That'll chop him up one on.
Oh, good down air.
C3PO is looking for the reset. It's my fault. It's the banana grab. Wasn't able to cancel out
good.
That dash into neutral.
Might have should have opted for a better aerial there, but we take this. Trades with Diddy, quite the accomplishment. Oh man, again 6WS. Something is just holding him back from finishing off Diddy Kong in this game.
I mean, it's really hard just to move in on Diddy. He's got so many opportunities and so many options. Really hard to predict what'll throw out, especially for such an experienced player. And the up smash.
And you get a combination of that banana and the detail. Sometimes it's just too much to bear.
Grab and okay, he's able to break out of it.
Oh,
throw
good.
The banana
job.
Up, yeah, because otherwise that would have. He had the opportunity to two frame that, so. Good thing he broke that up.
C3PO at 159, an excellent job.
All right,
banana
and
into the neutral air.
And he's on the board. So it won't be a silent reset here.
6WX trying to avoid the cardiac arrest. And now we're going to see C3PO's counterpick. I guess it's something like maybe Dreamland or Town and City.
Yeah.
Some of the low ceiling.
And I think 6WX is starting to get wise on how C3PO works. So I think expect this to be a lot more even than the past sets have.
It's a good counter pick by C3PO. Affords him a lot more stage room, a lot more flat stage room, more predictable platforms, and most notably a higher lower ceiling.
Wow, cut him off. And he's making me eat my words here. I thought 6WX was off to take another one, but.
I do think a more stable stage is benefiting C3PO.
Yeah, it's just that stage pick. He was
just like that, Sonic already has the percentage lead. There you go.
Good punish. Off that throw. The banana, yeah, he held back because the banana was behind him. And now he's just trying to find the right time to move in with that spin dash again. Sometimes all you need is pressure, so.
Yeah. Excellent job by 6WX trying to approach.
He's mainly going for that spin dash setup or a grab. So that would be one of the things that C3PO should be looking out for. I mean, those are usually Sonic's bread and butter, like, to get a lot
tries
of
to go for that banana. Oh, and forward smash punishes the monkey flip.
And he's holding on the banana too, so C3PO doesn't have a chance to get another one.
I like what 6WX did right there. C3PO has been going on stage with that monkey flip safely all game. And finally, the one time he does punish it, it was for a KO. Came at right the right time. And that is...
Oh, wow, what a whiff!
Whiffs the punish. I don't think C3PO is happy about that whatsoever. Uh-oh.
I thought we would have seen more out of that. Maybe
here
you
go.
Stop lap. Oh, no,
here comes Sonic's signature pressure in the air. Really hard to air dodge against Sonic.
Don't want
to
go on this top platform, C3PO. Especially with the percentage that you are now, and Sonic's got a good amount of rage on him, too, so. Keep it on stage. Back throw that.
Back throw almost lands on the platform.
Yeah, that's the thing I was looking out for.
So they're almost an even percentage, but 6WX has a whole percentage.
Yeah, he's got the stock.
Or whole stock, excuse me. Excellent job right now.
Uh-oh,
this is not going to be good. And that almost still in stock. That was interesting.
Oh, what a spike from C3PO.
Reads the offstage attempt by 6WX. And
yeah.
That's the second or third time that 6WX has died to that.
Right now, yeah, Sonic can chill because he's got the no percent on there. He knows that C-3PO has to move in to get the percentage that he needs in order to turn this around.
Yeah, 145. C-3PO is definitely fighting an uphill battle. Mm.
And now Sonic's 6WX's playstyle, just moving in when he needs to, is just even more enhanced by this.
And right now, with no platforms in the stage, it's kind of Sonic's platform.
Right. The trip up hitting Diddy there. Platforms move in. Try to get the clap in front and nothing like that. And an up throw.
And it almost does it.
Yeah, the banana kind of slipped him off, so he wasn't able to approach, but a clean down tilt.
Ooh, almost gets the spring. 6WS can almost take his time right now.
Oh, sorry, that was forward throw. That's my fault.
This WX feeling no pressure whatsoever, only a 10% and 183.
Yep.
He does not need to do anything risky, but that will probably do it. Forward throw does take it.
183, he needs to be a little more cautious than that. And Sonic. 6WX brings it back 2-2.
Sonic with a low-key taunt in the victory screen.
And this will be reset or winner.
So we're probably going to see another Town and City, if not something like Dreamland.
Smashville?
Smashville.
All right.
Really? That's got to be a gentleman's agreement. Because I'm pretty sure C-3PO won on this already.
Yeah, most likely. That was it's a 2-2 now, right?
Yeah, it's 2-2 right now. 6WX is up right in the winner's final. Oh, again, that banana just stuffs out the spin dash so well. Vex sent C-3PO into losers, but in losers, C-3PO took out Vex.
Yeah. Just answering a question in chat there. So we see Sonic trying to close in.
Here we go. Really good neutral game right now from both.
It looked like he was trying to go for an aerial there, but because he had the banana, it made him throw the banana up instead.
And again, like I said, Smashville's a good stage for characters who like to play defensively and like to take their time. You can really take your time in the platform, get your strategy going.
Right. Good strength for
C-3PO. Good job by C-3PO. Oh, very interesting option by 6WX. But
right back is 6WX. Even percentages and just playstyle right now.
Just the last part. A little bit out of it.
Yeah. Spring sends him off.
Oh, that was an interesting option by 6WX, just opting to go for that raw off smash.
Yeah.
Oh, we always got to pop the balloon here.
Always go for the balloon kill.
Uh-oh, this forward throw. We got to knock him in a disadvantageous position.
Yeah, stage presence is key right now. Like what C-3PO did, he just used the character model to move the banana forward instead of grabbing it and replacing it.
Oh, good banana by C-3PO, but just guesses incorrectly. But excellent attempt. And that back air almost takes the stock.
And very nice. Yeah. Wasn't entirely read in terms of when it came out, but it was good awareness from C-3PO.
And we're going to see how 6WX responds here. Manages to get that down throw. Oh, good neutral air. Beats out the recovery by C3PO.
Has to get a grab, yeah.
Both of the players try to go for grabs on the very edge of the stage frequently. And this could be it. And it is it. 6WX managed to tie the game, and then we're down to one stock each in grand final set one.
Yep, C3PO needs to take this in order to force a reset, and 6WX needs to take it in order to claim victory. Let's see which will happen.
It's been fantastic play so far.
So far, C3PO.
Right now, 6WX is feeling a little bit of damage pressure. Really doesn't like to be in a position where he doesn't have control of the stage, but right now he's trying to gain it back. Good job by C3PO for just optimizing DI on that and getting out of the forward air.
Lapping him on percents here.
Good back air.
Stage presence too. This is
reads it.
All it takes is a good banana placement or a down tilt.
This is not good for C3PO.
Very nice backwards movement there, able to avoid the back air, which probably would have done him in. Oh, gets a trip, but a miss
good
on the
job.
Lead.
Excellent job right now by 6WX. He's just tagging on more damage.
Yeah, he's aware of the banana play, and he's just knowing when to, when C3PO is trying to throw it towards him. So he knows
A really weird trade, but.
Oh, Sonic almost got there. Back throw.
It's not going to take the stock, but it's definitely going to send Diddy off stage, and which Diddy does not like to be in. Oh, almost gets hit by forward air. Good air
back down.
Oh, punishes with a raw neutral B.
Banana. He's got a play key. Oh, so that was so close. But the latch
mix
on.
Up.
Mm-hmm. And now he's
now
got
Sonic's kind of not at a great kill percentage. C3PO's not out of this just yet.
And he just can't get on this main platform. C3PO just doing a great job going back and forth, just creating pressure just by movement alone.
Oh,
it's a throw. Oh, great roll.
Tries to go
back air. Great air dodge. Oh, this is so tense.
Oh, almost gets that. Diddy Kong at 145%,
way,
a little bit too much rage.
One slip up is all it
takes
here.
Gets out of it. Diddy Kong at 153, that's a lot of rage. One good forward air could take the stock.
Oh, he's got to be careful when he throws that up and at it because that leaves him open. Because he throws it up in the air and Sonic can dash right in and get the attack that he needs. Back
uh-oh,
row.
That might do it.
Oh, all right.
6WX takes grand finals here at Brotherly Love. You have your champion. Woo. Sonic the Hedgehog.
Yeah, fantastic 6WX. Effort from C3PO. Just to give him a mention, like, he created so much pressure with just banana and just, he knew when to move in on Sonic, and that is a hard task to do.
That's very difficult.
Yeah.
Very difficult.
But as you just saw, 6WX able to read some of C3PO's movement, and he will take, like you said, the winners of Brotherly Love 15 Smash 4 singles.
Yes, congrats to 6WX for taking once again another Brotherly Love.
Mm-hmm.
And good job to C3PO, who always does well when he comes here.
Oh,
he always
does
well wherever he goes. So make sure that you follow their Twitter and follow their Facebook.
Oh, yeah. Like I tweeted them out, so if you can find mine or whatever. It's Circa 6WX and what is it, C3PO Smash?
I believe it is, yes.
Okay. I'll just check mine just to be sure. Come on here. Yes, it's at Circa underscore 6WX, capital C, capital W, capital X, and at C3PO Smash, capital C, capital P, capital O, capital S for Smash. So yeah, make sure you follow those two guys. Diddy Kong, 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 Kong.
So just to recap, today your winner is 6WX, C3PO will be taking second place. Vex will be taking third place. Redeemer Z will be taking fourth place. Esquire, myself, and Project AEX will be taking fifth place. And Uno and T-Sauls will be taking...